Hi, my name is Pat Koszczaba, and you are watching a NETTAT series about agile design patterns. Today, we will talk about the factory pattern, one of the most used and most useful design patterns ever defined. Let's imagine we are required to create a shopping cart capable of keeping a list of products. These products will be implemented by the keyboard and the mouse objects. The product will be an interface defining all the methods that keyboard and mouse has to implement. Creating this object will be done in the shopping cart. If we would to implement the UML schema you saw, we should use a private variable. Let's just call it products in the cart. To populate our list of products, we will use a simple function. Let's call it add, having a parameter a product ID. If our product based on its ID is a keyboard, we will add a new keyboard to our private variable, the products in the cart array. Otherwise, we will just create a new mouse and add it. The next step will be to decide if our product is a keyboard or a mouse based on its ID. So let's create our private function isKeyboard. Having a parameter, a product ID. For our simple example, I will just assume that any product ID starting with the letter K will be a keyboard. This solution may work, but it has a little problem. The add method has to know both about how to create the keyboard and the mouse objects and when to create them. Imagine that keyboard and mouse would have a lot of parameters in their constructor. That would be a lot of knowledge encapsulated in a single and simple method, which is called add. The add method should be responsible of adding the keyboard and the mouse to the array and not deciding what to do with them and how to create them. So let's move all this knowledge into another private method here. Let's call it makeProductFromID. This private method will be responsible of calling the isKeyboard and deciding if we should create a keyboard or a mouse. Instead of adding the new objects to the array, we will just return them. Now, the add method should be also modified to call this makeProductFromID and add the returned value to its array. What we did here was to move the logic from the add method to an isolated place, but also inside our class. This is called the factory method pattern. It is useful when you know that the creation will be made only inside the current object. If you think you will have to use this function from another place, from another class, or from another module of your application, you should think of creating a full-blown factory pattern. This can be best exemplified by the following UML schema. In our case, the shopping cart will use a totally different object called product factory. This product factory will then have the knowledge of creating keyboard and mouse. This way, we will decouple shopping cart from both keyboard and mouse, and we will hide the knowledge of creating these objects from our business logic. Our business logic will be responsible of only keeping the list of products. It will not know how they are made, how they are created, and why they are created. To implement this solution, first, we will have to move all the creation logic from shopping cart to another class. Let's just take everything out. Open the Product Factory class and insert everything here. But before I will continue, let's look a moment at the implementation of mouse, product and keyboard. Product is very simple. It's just an interface and it will have only three functions for our simple example. Let's say we'll have a get price to finding out the price of a product. We'll have a get picture, which will provide the picture of the product in discussion, and a function which will provide a nice description for us. Now, if we jump to keyboard and we specify that it implements the product interface, we can just call an implement all methods in our IDE and it will complete the get description, get picture and get price. For this example, let's just return a simple description as a string. Let's say our object has no picture and it has a price of 50. We don't care about the currency at this point. If we were to implement the mouse class, that would be very similar, but I will just add the required methods and do nothing more right now. Remember, we just took all the knowledge from the shopping cart and moved it to the product factory. But you may ask yourself, how would the shopping cart know about the factory? Well, the shopping cart will have another private variable where it will keep a reference to the product factory. To set this variable, we can use the constructor of the shopping cart. This product factory will be equal to a new product factory. This way, we ensure that the shopping cart is connected to the factory and nothing more. But the factory at this point has no public methods. We just moved everything there and everything was private. So let's just remove the private from the make function and change its name to a simple make. The rest is redundant. We have to do nothing else in the product factory. This is the whole logic of creating our objects. Now, back in shopping cart, the only change we have to do is that instead of calling a private method which creates the object, we will call our product factory and the make method on it with the product ID we just got. This is a factory pattern as implemented usually. Some may say that a factory interface is required or recommended. In some situations, you can do that and connect the shopping cart to a factory interface. But in PHP, such extra interface for the factory is not required and usually not used. So let's review a little bit more our schema. The main idea here is to move the creational logic and the decision logic of creating objects from the business logic outside of the core of our application into a factory object. If you take a look at a high-level architectural schema, you will see that the business logic resides in the center of our application. Factories, entry points, persistence layers, communication channels, and user interfaces are all outside of the business logic and its boundaries. This is very important so that the core of our application can concentrate on what is important for our business and not on details such as how to create objects. That would be all for today. See you next time when we will talk about the gateway design pattern.